What's up everybody, my name is Dwight and welcome back to GeForce Garage. Today we're going to be building our very first Turing-powered gaming PC using our GeForce RTX 2080. So I finally got my hands on an RTX 2080, so I thought it would only be appropriate to build a gaming PC somewhere around the $2,000 range. We're going to be building it inside the Corsair Crystal 280X, which is a small form factor chassis, and it has three glass panels on it so we can see all of our new hardware. I've never actually built a PC in this case yet, so I'm actually really excited to do so. The first part that we'll start with is the ASUS ROG Strix Z370 motherboard. This is the micro ATX version, so it has built-in Wi-Fi, and it's the perfect gaming motherboard for a small form factor PC. To go with that, we have 16 gigs of Corsair Vengeance LED RAM, and it's at 3000 megahertz, but we'll try to bump it up a little bit past that. And a Toshiba M.2 NVMe 480 gig, which is plenty of space for all of our games, and they're gonna load lightning fast. We have the i7-8700K, which is one of the better gaming CPUs out there right now. To keep that thing cool, we need a Corsair H100i. I opted for this all-in-one over the other ones just because I've used these a bunch. They're super easy to install and they work great. It's all powered by the HX 750 watt power supply. And because cable management is a big deal in a case that has a bunch of glass windows in it, we sprung for the cable kit as well. All right, so those are all the parts. Now let's clear off this table and get to building. Well, here it is in all of its glory. It looks super sleek and clean. Working inside of this case was actually a lot easier than I expected. Cable management is usually a problem when it comes to small form factor cases, but with this one, there is a rear chamber where you can put a lot of the slack of the cables back there. And with these sleeved cables from Corsair, they're much easier to train and they look great. The USB 3.0 was wonky, but you kind of have to just do what it wants without ruining the pins. The other thing that I really liked about the case is that all the fan filters are magnetic, so it makes them easy to take off and clean them when you need to. The only other thing that I could really say about the case is that I'm not a big fan of how the front glass is mounted. This one you have to like hold it up and screw it down at the same time, and I wish there was a way to stabilize it before putting it on. I just don't like all the weight of the glass being on the screws. But as a system, the true test comes after we install a couple of games. So let's go see how well it performs. So after installing Windows 10 and updating everything, I loaded up 3D Mark TimeSpy and was surprised by, I think, our highest score in one of these build guides at 10,481. In fact, I ran TimeSpy on my own personal gaming rig not too long ago and was shocked to see that it scored 870 points less than this new one. And I have an i7-5960X, 32 gigs of RAM, and a GTX 1080 Ti. Either I need to overclock more or maybe it's time I update my rig. First game I checked out was Counter-Strike Global Offensive, which was able to maintain 280 to 300 frames a second at 1440p, even through these insane firefights between bots. PUBG still won't let me use DxTory to monitor frames per second, but at 1440p with everything turned up, stayed above 100 FPS easily, even with me chucking grenades constantly and everyone firing at the practice range. Fortnite also didn't like my FPS counter, but it has a built-in one, so at 1440p, on ultra-high settings, we stayed above 110 FPS, even through firefights, regardless of how mediocre my skill at the game was. For some reason, Overwatch didn't like my 1440p monitor and locked me to 1080p, but at that resolution and on ultra-high settings, we averaged around 180 frames per second during fights. Assassin's Creed Odyssey on ultra-high settings at 1440p, we got an average frame rate of 72, while in Shadow of the Tomb Raider with the same settings, we got 80 frames per second. In the MOBAverse, each game on the highest setting and at 1440p, we averaged around 160 frames per second in Heroes of the Storm, 200 to 240 in League of Legends, depending on how intense the fight was, and just over 200 in Dota 2. So not only does it look good, but it also has the numbers to back it up. Not bad for our first Turing-powered PC. If you want to see more RTX build guides, be sure to hit that subscribe button down below. We'll see you for the next one.